Welcome back to this Guild Wars Let's Play. You're Sambo, and joining us as always is Seraphis Heals a Lot, and of course, the wonderful, the purple, the furry legged Regina Lacerda. How are you this evening, Reggie?
I'm well. How are you, Sambo?
I'm alright. Actually, you don't sound that well. You haven't got a cold again, have you? Or rather, you haven't dropped your other cold. Have you still got a cold? Is what I'm trying to say.
I don't know if I've still got a cold or I've got a cold again or I'm just, you know, just permanently with a cold, but cold.
That's no good. Gosh, you and between you and Tallahassee, I don't know what you two get up to, but touch wood, I seem to be the only one that doesn't actually have a cold at the moment. But anyway, welcome.
Suggesting there? I've never actually met him in person.
No, I wasn't suggesting that. I meant that you both must be burning the candle at both ends or something like that, wearing yourselves down and letting a cold take hold or something. Whereas I am a picture of perfect health.
I have commitments and have things to do and, I'm not sitting back on my...
No, my middle name is Healthy, you see. You should take a leaf out of my book. You know, I know how to look after my body. My body is a temple. You know, I mean, I do yoga every day. I go and tend my herb garden before I get up and go for work.
Where did you put the herb garden?
Okay, maybe I'm exaggerating just a
little
bit.
Do you have it on
the
back of your toilet or something?
Oh dear, okay, yeah, actually, mental note to self, never try and pull the wool over your viewers' eyes when you have someone that you know in real life with you. Whoops. Anyhow.
Herb garden, yoga. I know the only kind of yoga you get up to.
Whoa! That's right, it's squashing onto the busy tram every morning because I'm required to flex and stretch and, you know, yeah. Anyway, let's move right away from that one, shall we?
Now, use the lift rather than the stairs at work.
I've got a condition, okay? And so, you know, I have to be very careful about the amount of physical exercise I do. Yes, that condition is called laziness, but it is a condition.
Being a head case is not a condition.
It is still a condition. You know, laziness is... You look up on Wikipedia. Laziness is a condition that I suffer from.
Yeah, there is. There's a photo of you.
Oh, gosh, you're so charming. Here I am trying to cheer you up with your cold, and you're still nasty to me. I don't know. Things never will change. Anyhow, one thing I do know... and we were talking before we started filming, of course, and you let me know that we are right smack in the middle of, well, actually at the end of festival time. We've got the Dragon Festival going on.
Actually,
is this correct?
Yeah, well, pretty much the festival is mostly over. There's a few of the games left, and some tokens can be handed in still, but as far as meeting the Emperor or, you know, being... fully in with the festival activities. You've missed it, my boy.
Oh, that is so annoying. And you know what? It's funny because we were talking beforehand and I've had such a busy schedule this week. It's been horrible. And Reggie and I have been talking. It's like, yeah, let's do the festival. Yep, it's going to be great. And of course, I know a lot of you guys wanted us to film the festival. Oh, look, she's playing the world's smallest violin for me. And so, of course, I call her up tonight and I say, right, let's get on with it and let's do the festival. And she says, Sambo, it's finished. I'm thinking, what the heck? So, yeah, I'm very, very sorry about that. But, I do know, because you were telling me before, that if we actually get to Shing Jea Monastery, which, of course, where the festival is held, you said that, yes, there's still some mini-games available, and you've been doing the festival for the last few days, haven't you? Like, you've actually been participating, not on Reggie here, of course, but on one of your other characters.
I have.
All right. Okay, so...
Yes, on my character, Posey.
Posey, rightio. Well, here's what I propose-y. Oh, I'm so good. Anyway, here's what I propose. If you guys at home don't mind, what we might do is, because there's a few remnants of the Dragon Festival left, why don't we whip on over to our other tunes and we get Reggie to show us around the Shing Jea Monastery and show us what we missed out and perhaps participate in whatever mini games are left, because it's a once a year opportunity, isn't it? I think it's only once every year, is that right?
I think it is. The Dragon Festival is only once a year, sort of, right. You know, a mid-year thing.
Okay, Right, and of course, you know, like you said, it is mid-year, and that's to coincide with probably the US midsummer. And I know for a fact that right now in WoW, and I know you hate me talking about WoW, Reggie, but right now in WoW there is the Midsummer Festival, or it's coming up to the end of it as well, because of course the other thing, big thing for you guys in the States, is that it's July the 4th. So by the way, happy Independence Day, to all of our US listeners. All right, Reggie.
Yeah, happy Independence Day for us, but this is going to be viewable not on Independence Day, so by the time it gets released.
Well,
that's true.
Well, it's a belated Independence Day happy thing. Right.
Wished you Independence Day for the past.
Yeah. A minor setback. Anyway, what I think we should do is we should use some of our technical wizardry and do some abracadabra and just magically transform onto our other characters and magically teleport all the way over to the Shing Jea Monastery, which of course, by the way, folks, is a faction's location. So look at her. She's all getting ready. Actually, I need to do that. How do you do that again? Is it attention?
Attention.
There we go. Right, so we're both ready. So, yes, don't forget, folks, if you've just got Guild Wars Prophecies... now, Reggie, correct me if I'm wrong here, but I don't think you... Can you... Because if you don't have factions, can you actually go to the Shing Jea Monastery? I don't know. I've always had all three expansions, so I'm not sure.
I don't think you can, no.
Okay, so that's something. If you only have prophecies, make sure you go out and get factions for next year. All right, so here we go. I think with the magic... Whoa, look at her, she's gone. Oh my god, she teleported. I'm going to have a much better way of doing this. I'm going to use some magic. So here we go. I've got to get myself ready for this. Takes a lot of psychic power. Here we go. And abracadabra. Woohoo, look at that. By the power of magic, gosh, I'm good. I've now teleported myself to the Shing Jea Monastery and I've changed character. I'm now on a mana ritualist. And hopefully, Reggie, are you here somewhere? Oh, hang on.
I'm over here, Sambo.
There you go. Posy Lacerta. Let's invite her to the party. And let's go over and say hello. There you go. So you magically changed characters as well.
I have. I'm
look at that.
An assassin ranger.
Oh, wow. And I love the outfit.
Well, I picked ranger up with this because I quite like using the ranger in the other one. So I've picked Ranger up as a second profession for this.
Wow, that's awesome. And you've got amazing... Look at the outfit you've got on. This is... Wow. So there you go, folks. If you've never seen any factions content before, you are now feasting your eyes upon... Actually, I think you're feasting your eyes upon a couple of faction specific... classes, in fact, because of course the assassin is only available in factions, and as well as that, the ritualist, which is what I am here, I'm a ritualist necromancer. They're both classes.
Well, that's specifically why I chose assassin, because it is a new profession to this game, and it is, so thought I'd give it a try.
Yeah, and that's of course why I had my ritualist as well. So here we go. And of course, factions is very oriental, sort of canton themed. The whole zone is incredible. I just love it with the cherry blossoms. And of course, as you can see, looking around here, the very, very oriental architecture. It's amazing. But anyhow, here we are in the middle of Shing Jea. By the way, let's have a look at the map. You can see that we're on this island here, this great big island. We have a bunch of stuff. Of course, we're high level. I'm level, well, compared to our other toons, I'm level 12 and Posy is level 14 there, or Reggie, of course. And you can see we've got missions here, we've got different provinces on this little island here, which is where you start in factions, and there's snow and all sorts of amazing areas here. And if we zoom out, you can see...
It is a very ornate world, this one.
That's a good word for it, actually, Reggie. Ornate is perfect. And you can see over here, we've got this big blue and red line, which is the two factions, which is what this expansion is all about, the Kurziks and the Luxans. That's what that line there. You've got the Jade Sea, a whole bunch of stuff. And this, all of this, is a huge, great, big city. It's not until you go in there that you sort of understand exactly how big it is. It's absolutely amazing. Anyway, so that is the faction
city landscape. Is incredibly difficult to navigate.
Yeah, it's very large, isn't it? But anyway, we'll get there another day. What we're here to talk about today with our guide, of course, is Reggie. So, Reggie, I've done a couple of these in past years and absolutely loved it. And, of course, there's a number of things I'd love you to cover off, the very special things. And, of course, I can see people wearing one of the special things that I'm sure you'll tell us about there. Plus, of course, the activity. So why don't you give us a little rundown on what you've been up to here and what players can expect by participating in the Dragon Festival, by the way.
Well, one thing that I have been doing is collecting what's called victory tokens, and you can either get those as random drops from mobs, or you can get them as rewards for doing festival specific quests. And the victory tokens are exchanged, well, there's a few things they're exchanged for, but predominantly what they're exchanged for is every 2 hours the Emperor himself comes to the Shing Jea Monastery and gives you one of these.
Oh my lord! Hang on, we're just going to zoom in on you. I'm just going to move my character so we can get a close-up of you. You stay facing that way. I'm going to run past you so my camera's right in your face. Hang on. Let's have a look at this. Right, so, oh, look at that. You've got yourself a Dragon Festival mask. That is amazing, isn't it? You know what? I'm going to pause you right there because you're dead right. I actually have on this character from last year 7 victory tokens.
You're dead right. Drink.
No, I've got 7 victory tokens in my bags here, but I also have an Imperial Dragon mask. So what I want to do is, and this is from last year, I want to wear my one because, hang on, let's put it on, and I've got to show, there we go. All right, now, notice something, Reggie. I noticed something. They're different.
It's different.
Now, that's because, now, correct me if I'm wrong, but every year it's a unique and different mask, I think. Like, it's never
it
repeated.
It is, yes, yes.
Right. So, the
and
problem...
And if I will not be able to get that yellow mask, like, ever.
Yep, and unfortunately... Oh, for goodness sake, I'm trying to position myself, being a real spaz about it. There we go. Unfortunately for me, I'm not going to ever be able to get your mask either. That's... I'm really upset about that.
Well, theoretically...
What do you mean, theoretically? I can't. I haven't participated in the events. I've totally missed it, and I didn't get a mask.
Yeah, and you haven't been able to get any of the enough tokens to get a mask. However...
There's a however. You'd like to trade...
There's a however.
What you... Hang on. You're not going to...
There's... Okay. I have... 250 spare victory tokens that I would like to trade. I'm happy to give to you.
Pardon? You've got that, to be kidding.
I know, it doesn't happen very often.
No, but no, hey, yes. But wait a minute. Aren't victory tokens soulbound? Like customer, can you trade them?
Victory tokens can be traded. The masks can't be traded.
Right. So, oh, wait
so,
a minute.
So, you know, you can't...
So you're saying...
Yeah, so you can't...
So you're saying if you give me enough victory tokens, I can go to the... Is it the festival hats vendor in the background there and actually get myself a mask? Or do I have to...
No, well, there's actually a guy who will be appearing once all the festival things clear up. So I think it's even once all the games clear up as well. There is a guy, and I'm just trying to find here what his name is. Sorry, I'm just looking through the wiki. Once all the festival things have finished, he will come and he'll say, oh, look, you missed out, but I can still give you a mask anyway. And I think he's there for about a week after the festival finishes.
Wow.
His name is Imperial Supply Master Cagno.
Okay, so he's not here at the moment.
I haven't been able to find him here at the moment, but it says he will appear after the festival is finished to allow players that missed the final event to get a new mask.
Wow, and so therefore by you giving me enough tokens to do that, you've enabled me to get that mask from this year.
Yes, and what I'm also going to be offering you is, because also when the Emperor comes, if there's a little game that happens in the monastery itself while the Emperor's here, and if the game is won by the players and not by the baddies that spawn in, the Emperor gives out prizes to everyone who is standing in the monastery, and I've actually kept a couple of those prizes that I'm happy to give to you.
Hang on, can you please go and get Reggie? You're clearly an imposter. Whoa.
No, well, I'm not Regina Lacerta. I'm Posy Lacerta.
Oh, of course. Oh, boy. Oh, sorry, I was getting you mixed up there. You should try dealing with your sister. Seriously, what a horror. She's a real witch, I tell you. You, on the other hand, you are lovely. Look at this. We've got up here 250 victory tokens and a festival prize. I don't believe that. Am I allowed to open the festival prize?
You are, and for some reason, I've actually got three festival prizes I was going to give you, but it's only dropped one in there.
Oh, come on. Well, let's open
put
one
the
anyway.
Maximum in. There we go. Offer. There we go.
And I've got. Okay. Oh, look at this.
There's another two coming.
That is so kind of you. There we go. Look at that. I've got myself a red bean cake. You know what? That brings back so many memories. I do remember getting these in the past. Now, that should have accepted that offer, by the way. Did that work for you, the trade?
Yes. It should have come through.
And what else have we got here? Oh, we got some victory tokens, and we got more victory tokens, so that's really handy. I must say, thank you so much. That's so awesome, because, of course, I haven't been able to log in due to being so busy, and here you are slaving away getting... I mean, I know how much it takes to get 250 victory tokens, so I think this calls for a bow. There we go. A very humble, deep bow. Thank you very, very much, because I know how much effort goes into that. It's very kind of you. And especially seeing
that's
as it means...
That's all right.
Well, I'm going to be able to... I'm going to run over to the festival hats guy over here, but I've got a funny feeling he's only going to have the ones that I've already got. Like you say, we're going to have to wait for that other NPC. I want to show you a new hat. Please look at my Imperial Dragon mask. This doesn't look too tricky. Come back anytime. I can make you or anyone on your account a copy of that hat. Please make me a new hat. Make me a demon mask or an imperial dragon mask. Now, is yours called a demon or what's it called, the actual mask?
It's actually called a merciful dragon mask.
Okay, so I've obviously got a pattern for another one called a demon mask here as well. So I must have got that on another character, I guess. I'm going to buy you that. It's worth 10 gold. I'm going to buy that. There we go. And we'll wear that, and we'll see what it looks like.
I think you've shown us that one before.
Oh, I have too. Yep, there it is. So that's something a bit different again. Yeah. All right, we'll put on the other one.
Well, if you come up this way, there is a guy who, because you've got some more victory tokens than you need, there is a guy up here which actually exchanged the victory tokens for... a few little, like, more fun things.
Oh, okay. Let's follow Reggie.
Over this way.
Here we go. Oh, this brings back memory. And, of course, I know the game you're talking about. It's you have to pick up the presents, don't you, or whatever they are, and you have to run and drop them off up near the gate there. It's lots of fun. I had lots of fun with this last year. All right. So
this one was actually candles. You had to pick up the candles and drop them off to... a priest or someone before these baddies that had spawned into the monastery tag you, and when you're tagged, you die for a few
seconds.
That's
right. And it's heaps of fun, isn't it? I do love the fact that they organise these events. Yeah, I spent hours playing in here. And yes, you're dead right. Look at this, the victory tokens here, where you can get some sugary blue drink. Yep, some bottle rockets. That's like a, and a sparkler, some fireworks there, and a champagne popper. Very cool. Love it. Now, seriously, I love your outfit, by the way, Reggie. What an awesome-looking assassin you are there with the knife blades, and that is such a cool mask this year. So much better than the one I've got. That's amazing. And I just love being here as well. Now, I've noticed behind us we've got the Boardwalk Games vendor here, and if we talk to him, he says, send me to the Boardwalk Games. Now, you've obviously done these this year.
I have, yes. There was a couple of Boardwalk Games. There was where you stand on a disc and you had to use gaming tickets,
yep.
And then which cost you gold to buy. And then it was a random, like a game of chance. So you randomly either got like a shock or you got bonus tokens.
I remember that. I'm going to click on send me to the Boardwalk Games. Now, I don't know if you'll follow.
No, I'm not following because... Oh. Theoretically, you're still in the monastery.
Oh, okay. Well, I've just come through here. What happens if you come through? Oh, there you go. Yay. All right, so here we go. Here's some typical examples of, by the way, the architecture here. And, I mean, look at that. You've got this great big snake here. Look at the detail in the modelling there. Remembering, of course, this is a very old
blossoms.
Game now. And the cherry blossoms and everything. It's just incredible, isn't it? I love it. Absolutely love it. All right, so who do we talk to?
Well, where I'm standing at the moment is actually where one of the games was occurring. But, yeah, it's not... It's sort of still happening, but the game board itself has disappeared.
Oh, and that's because the festival's over. So we're too late, in other words, are we?
Yeah, yeah.
And there wasn't
and then
there
down here...
Yeah, isn't there another one somewhere?
Yeah, down here there is, see where this red gate is down the bottom?
Yep.
There was a game where you had to tag, they look like worms. They were called hatchlings, but they look like the worms that we had in the field.
Right.
And, yeah, so the person who tagged the most would get victory tokens.
Right. So they're cool little, oh gosh, look at the view. Will you look at the view? Oh, I love this expansion so much. Seriously, folks, if you're watching this and you don't own Factions, just go out and buy it. Trust me. It's a beautiful, beautiful expansion full of content.
The detail they have in this game, the things they put in that they don't have to put in. Like, there's temples everywhere. You just wander through the landscape and there's temples and there's waterfalls and there's...
Yeah.
It's just bridges everywhere and it's beautiful.
It is. It's absolutely outstanding. All right, well, look, my apologies, Reggie, that we missed out on being able to film this, but I'm really pleased that you got to have a go in them. Is this your first Dragon Festival?
It is, actually. I don't know how I've managed to miss it up until this point, but, yeah, it is the first Dragon Festival I've participated in.
Wow. Well, I hope you had lots of fun. And, of course, there's more content as well, if I remember rightly... I'm sure you know what I'm going to say, but my most favourite part of the whole festival was a particular race. Now, I don't suppose that's still... I can see you behind the gate there. Hello. I don't suppose...
I'm just going to pop through the gate. There we go.
There you go. I suppose we've missed out on my racing, right? And, I mean, look, why don't you explain to us all about it? But
Maybe not. I think you might be talking about the roller beetle racing.
I am. This guy here. So I guess there's
it
not much point.
It is heaps of fun.
But it's over,
no,
right?
No, like if you talk to him, I think he does still have the race going.
Really? Oh, actually, before I do, I just thought of something as well. Here we go. Now, guys at home watching, just quickly, if you know Guild Wars at all, you know that you have districts in Guild Wars. And, of course, a district is basically a whole new instance of the game that spawns when there are too many players in one instance. So, in other words, it's not unusual to have sort of 6 or 7 versions of the game running at the same time. And, of course, you know, it's interesting because people say, oh, gosh. Gosh, yeah, not unusual. Some people say, oh, why do you play Guild Wars? Nobody plays it anymore. It's an old game and all the rest of it. Well, for a start.
Nobody schmobody.
Exactly.
Everyone plays Guild Wars at festival time, at least.
Especially. I mean, if I hold down my control key here, you can see that we're absolutely surrounded by players. And we are in the 14th district. But it doesn't stop there, folks. Watch what happens when I drop this menu down. Watch this. It's going. There are currently 196 instances of the game running. And apparently, each instance of the game holds... I don't know what the real number is, and I don't know if they've actually released it, but it's in the thousands. So... You tell me that there's nobody playing Guild Wars with 196 instances of it running. That is utter rot.
Well, there was actually times when I was talking to people and they were like, oh, I'm in such a district, and I couldn't get in. Like, I'd be trying to change district to go and meet up with them and I couldn't get to them. I was like, nope, this district's full. Choose again.
Right, just because it's so packed out. Look, sorry, I've changed the subject there. Take me to the roller beetle racing track. I'm going to be so upset, I know, because I loved this particular racing. I'm really annoyed that we missed it because I... Hey, we're in. Oh.
Missed it.
Oh, look at this. And there you are. Oh, and you've changed your... Okay. We need to explain what's going on here. Hey, look at her. She's dancing. Okay, I'm going to dance as well. Hang on. All right, Reggie, this is your show. You tell us what on earth is going on with these. What the heck? We're a beetle. What is going on?
Well, these are roller beetles, and what you'll find is each time you spawn in, your beetle changes colour. So
right.
you can't pick your colour. Unfortunately, so I can't always spawn in as a purple beetle. But you can pick your pattern. So here I've picked a nice peace pattern that's sort of flowers and...
Look at that. You've got
peace symbol and...
Yeah, the peace symbol. Very hippie. Very nice. Mm. But can't... Oh, look at these people. They've got purple, they've got yellow. So hang on, can't you actually change the... You said you can change the pattern. How do you do that?
You've got to go to this guy over here, Beetle Designs.
Ah.
And then you choose the pattern you want, and then he'll, take money from you to do it, but...
All right, so we've got racing stripes, we've got eight ball, peace, love, and understanding, tiger stripes, wing, and eyeball. Okay, so what's racing stripe look like? 100 gold? Oh, I'm going to think that over. Ouch. Oh, and there's an eyeball. Somebody's chosen the eyeball one. And there's racing stripes. All right, see, this was one of my favorite parts of the game. So, is the battle still actually working? So it's still up, is it? Even though the festival's over, they've still kept this going.
They have, yeah. I don't know how much longer it's going to go for, but it's still going.
All right, well, basically, folks, let's explain this very quickly. You can see when you're a roller beetle, this is so much fun. Basically, think of Mario Kart. I'm sure all of you have played Mario Kart before. You go in a race, and I think there's four or five or six. Actually, I can't remember how many are in a race, but, you know, a few. And it's just like Mario Kart. There's a track to follow. Not only that, but you roll across crates. There's power-up crates that appear in the track that you're all trying to fight for. And they give you all sorts of different boosts and speed and armors and all sorts of things. We'll go through that in a second. But basically, along your skill bar here, you have a whole bunch of new skills specifically for your beetle. And you can see here we've got Roller Beetle Dash, which is a skill that for 5 seconds you move extremely fast. Got another one here, Hardened Shell. For 4 seconds you can't be knocked down. We've got a Ram that knocks all adjacent roller beetles down so you can attack your other players. And then the rest of these are picked up from the skill boxes that you run over in the game. And you can see they all do different things. For 20 seconds, this skill is replaced with the next skill you use. You can spit rocks at a target roller beetle. All of a target roller beetle's skills are disabled for 5 seconds. So it's very much like throwing red shells and dropping bananas and all the rest of it. I mean, I reckon anyway. What do you reckon, Reggie? Honestly, it's Super Mario Kart, basically.
I know, yeah. Absolutely it is.
Which is, you know, so cool. There's absolutely nothing wrong with that. So I say, while it's still going, and I know we're running over time, folks, by the way, my apologies, but this is a very special...
Race.
Yep, very race, special. So race, let's do a race. So let's see if we can get in the same one, Reggie. So we're going to count down from five, and then we'll hit enter battle. And that's how you get into the race, by the way, folks. You just up the top right here under your minimap, you just click enter battle. I'm going to go 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and then on the zero, let's hit enter battle and see if we get in a race together. Are you ready?
Cool.
Mm-hmm. All right, here we go. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, enter battle. Here we go. And time until mission starts is 3, 2, 1. Hopefully we get in the same race. Oh, she's gone and I stayed. Damn, that means we didn't get in the same race because, of course, it's so busy. Well, it's so busy. There's so many races going on all the time. Whoa, he's got some cool racing stripes there. But what
for some reason, I'm downloading files. I've been playing this and yet I've got files to download again.
Oh, good Lord. Wow.
Oddness of Guild Wars.
We'll see what happens. Maybe I still will end up in the same mission as you. I'm about to go in now. Here we go. Roller Beetle Racing is loading. We'll see if I start in the same party as you. And your mind's downloading files again too, which is a bit odd. Oh my goodness.
I can't wait to knock you off the track.
Is that you next to me? No, no, no.
Oh, I'm still loading files.
Oh.
I'm not sure why I'm still loading files.
Damn,
it wasn't that long ago that I was playing a game of it.
I know. Oh, that's awful. All right. Well, sorry, Reggie, but I can't get out of this. So here we go. You can see, folks, it actually shows you first, second, and third place. We're going to use our speed up skill here. I'm also going to use my hardened shell ability because no doubt somebody will try and knock me over. Now, Reggie, let us know when you get in the race as well. Oh, somebody knocked me
down. I will. I'll keep you updated.
Yes, please. I'm in about fifth place, way behind, lagging behind here. And of course.
Of course,
Shishu. By the way, there's a couple of shortcuts as well that I learned over the years. But do you know what? We are definitely disadvantaged being in Australia. I definitely know that we have lag issues that can always pretty much prevent us from winning, unfortunately.
You have other issues that prevent you from winning.
Oh, hush you. Hush. So now, folks, when you play this, you can either use the WASD to steer or you can right mouse button steer. Now, there are the crates, by the way.
Or you can use your arrow keys.
Yes, you can use your arrow keys too. Those crates were the power-ups. Adjacent enemies are knocked down. There we go. We knocked down that guy. Oh, but we got stuck on a piece of scenery as well. Dear, oh dear. And I'm waiting for my other skill, my dash, to come up, by the way, because I really desperately need that. So I'm going to pick up... Oh, there we go. And we're going to dash. We can see first place is someone called Dragon. Next place is Lady Yananuchi. And then only Afro Samurai is in third place. Oh, and I got stunned. Nasty, nasty. How are you going, Reggie?
It keeps dropping me back into the practice area.
Oh, so it's not being nice to you.
It doesn't want me to race, no.
No, we see, that's what happens when you're too good. They don't want you to have a disadvantage the rest of the field. So clearly that's why.
Trust me, Sambo, that is not the reason.
All right, I don't know what place I'm in, but it's not first, second, or third. But hey, we're having fun anyway. Oh, need that power up. There we go. Right, let's see if I can at least get to the guy in front of me and try and knock him down. Although he's zooming ahead. Alright, we're coming up on the end now. So, there you go, folks. You can see it's what I mean by it's very Super Mario Kart. Look at this. It's even got, basically, this is the beach section of Mario Kart as well. Classic. Right, spit rocks. We've got a power up where we can spit rocks at a target roller beetle, and if they hit, that target is knocked down. We've got 18 seconds remaining. Are we going to make it? Coming up on gate number 7, which is right near the very end. 12, 11. Oh, it's going to be a close one. 6, 5, 4, 3, 2. I'm just not going to make the checkpoint. Oh, look at that. Oh, your party was
defeated.
You can't
even finish the race.
I can't finish the race. That's terrible. Well, at least it's better than not being able to start it, Reggie. I don't know why. Whatever, she says. All right, where are you? Are you still out the front here?
Hi.
There you are. All right,
purple now.
Oh, and I'm red now with racing stripes of fire. All right, let's try this one more time, see if we can get a race together. Are you ready?
Ready as I'll ever be.
All right, and so it's on the zero. So here we go. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0. Entering battle. Time until mission starts, 20 seconds. What have you got?
I've got a warning.
What does that mean?
You must wait for your dishonorable status to expire before you can enter a PvP match.
Okay, I'm cancelling then. What the heck is going on with you? Oh, you have got a status on you. If I select you, you've got a hex on you. So what, did you quit the race or something?
No, I did nothing. I've just tried to load it and...
Well, okay, let's try that again.
It kept bumping me back into the practice area and now it... No, I've actually got, on my screen it actually says, dishonorable hex. There's a dishonorable hex spell. You are considered dishonorable because teammates repeatedly reported you for leeching, or because you repeatedly abandoned your team in random arenas, allied battles, or competitive missions. I've never done PvP.
Wow, that is very
bizarre. Well, other than Beetle Racing.
Well, I mean, yeah, technically it's PvP, but, that is most bizarre. Why don't you zone out and zone back in and see what happens? We'll wait for you here. And by the way, folks, if you never know how to get out of here, you have to speak to this guy here. And you can see it says, send me back. I'm done racing for now. So you saw Reggie disappear off there. We'll wait for you here, see if we can have another race with you. See if you drop that dishonorable tag, because that's most unusual.
Yeah, that is an oddity. I know.
It's the weirdest thing ever.
Because in Beetle Racing, you don't have teammates. So why would you have a dishonorable hex because you'd abandoned teammates?
I have absolutely no idea.
oh, the hex is still there, and it looks like it's actually recharged.
Oh, good Lord. All right, well, we might have to...
Oh, well.
Because you're a nasty abandoner, we might have to cancel the rest of the day's racing schedule, I think. So,
the game, no.
Oh, what a classic.
Oh, wow.
It's all right.
I'm just going to roll around the track instead.
It's okay. At least we got to see some beetle racing. And of course, that's just one more of the activities here at the Dragon Festival. So, as I said, it's a real shame that we did... Oh, I'm in District 69. It's a real shame that we actually got to miss seeing the Emperor come out because it's lots of fun. Look at all these players here with their dragon masks. And I used to love that, and it was so much fun doing that quest where you are chased around. That's very cool. I must admit, I agree with you on that one. That's fun.
Those mobs always go faster than you can go.
I know.
So you have to have like sugary drinks or the red bean cakes to be able to.
You're dead right. That's what they're for as well. And I love when the Emperor comes out because it's kind of, even though it sounds like nerdy, it's really cool. Because you kind of get this, you feel like someone important is coming to say g'day. There's a big build-up, and of course there's hundreds and hundreds of people around, and yeah, it's very cool. So, what district are you in, by the way, Reggie? Oh, there you are. You're behind us. Hello.
Yeah, I am. Hello.
Hello, hello. Let's get this silly mask off and put our normal hat back on, if I can take it off. All right, so there you have it, folks. We've gone way over time, but again, well worth it. As Reggie, thank you very, very much for the tokens. I can't wait. Now, you're going to have to keep on my back about this and make sure that I don't forget, because I do not want to miss out, after all your hard work, I do not want to miss out on getting that mask, because that would make all your hard work go to waste.
I know.
You'd be very annoyed at me then, yeah. So so please keep me posted on that one.
I would be super uber annoyed.
Even more so than normal. But there you go, folks. There it is. Not only a peek at the Shing Jea Monastery itself in factions. And by the way, Reggie, I'm sure that once we hit level 20 on our main tunes, we'll be coming back here to maybe do some run-throughs in the factions and indeed Nightfall, because we want to show everybody all the other expansions. But, you know, being here really makes me miss this place, because it's actually one of my favorite places in all of Guild Wars. And I love the classes and I love the armor. And once again, your character there looks absolutely fantastic. What an amazing looking tune. Well done on that, and thank you very much for the mask stuff and for my prezzies. So there you go, folks, there you have it. You've got a quick overview of the Dragon Festival with its mini games that aren't there anymore, the Beetle Racing that Reggie the PvP'er couldn't join. That was very bizarre. I don't know what made that happen. And of course, a quick very quick look at the different styles of armor that are available here, and all the different nice vistas. So maybe next year, Reggie, we'll be able to get to do it together, because I love it. I absolutely love it. I remember spending basically like 3 days in a row glued to my screen, having heaps of fun here. And I don't know what, maybe just one comment before we go from you, Reggie, about the community. Because one thing I remember about playing the games and the party atmosphere that's going on with the Dragon Festival is there were so many people. Again, looking at the district list, you can still tell there's still 196 instances open. But the atmosphere of people was just one of real fun and frivolity, and people were just having a good time and dancing and trading.
It was. Well, there was lots of lights up, like there were sort of coloured lights that were strung across the whole
the
monastery. And there was fireworks displays. But there were lots of people sort of running around with sparklers and their own personal fireworks displays and things and that. And then there was a lot more talking. Like, you know how you have the local chat.
Yep.
And, you know, sometimes there's a few people sort of, you know, saying obscenities backwards and forwards. But this was actually, there were people actually talking.
Right. And getting into that really cool party festival atmosphere. And look, it's been like that every other year. Honestly, it's just fantastic. And that's why I love it. And you get a real feeling of community. So I'm really annoyed that I missed it. But I'm so glad that you got to experience one. And oh my Lord, look at her dance.
Oh yeah.
Shake it.
The assassin goes for it.
Yeah, I'll say. What a classic. Well, I think that's it, folks. We do need to run away because we've run totally out of time. Whoa, there were some full-on splits you just did there. That was amazing.
I can do that in real life as well.
Of course you can. And I can do this yoga in real life as well. Anyhow. So once again, our major thanks to Reggie for collecting all those tokens for us, because I absolutely know, how much hard work you put into it. So thank you. And thanks for the tour of Shing Jea and what's left of the Dragon Festival. So, folks, there you go. I certainly hope you enjoyed that quick look at factions and the festival. Certainly hope you'll join us in the next episode. And, of course, on behalf of myself, Sambo, and the, who are we? We're Amana Ritualist. And, of course, the lovely Posy Lacerta, unlike her horrible sister. It's myself and Reggie saying take care. Have a great day. We'll see you next time. And bye-bye.
Bye-bye.